Chase over 3 miles. It's open. Look at that. 3 and 6 vying to be top dog, but joint favourites at the moment. Speak of the Devil and Absolutely Dylan. Let's get some thoughts from Andrew.
Yeah, wide open, the Richard Grummet Handicap Steeplechase, a belated birthday present. A quick word of Paul Henderson, who has Ballyhegan Hero. Aidan Coleman on board. Long journey up from Dorset to Wiltshire this morning. Left at 4 o'clock. He'd be hoping it's worthwhile.
And they're off. For the Richard Grummet Handicap Steeplechase, they have in front of them 3 miles and 19 fences, and the previous winner of the race, Classical Milano, heads on to the opening obstacle with the lead and gets over safely, followed by Ballyhegan Hero, who's over towards the inside. Absolutely Dylan coming to the first of the open ditches, fence number 2. In a dispute of third place, they're up towards the outside. Speak of the Devil jumps up nicely to share second spot. Back in fifth in the early part of the race is Blake Rigg, and then over to the inside is Hidden Cargo. 2 lengths back off these is Oscar Ceremony, who runs together with Shaughnessy, and 4 lengths back to Maison d'Or. So racing now over fence number 3. And they're all over. Ballyhegan Hero made quite a bad mistake at it, though, there, towards the inside. Just seemed to plunge at the fence, didn't get too high, and lost a good 2 to 3 lengths in getting from A to B, as they now work their way left-handed and continuing their journey away from us out towards the far side. And it is the 2019 winner, Classical Milano, who's been racing in point-to-points more recently than anything, comes over the next fence only a head or so to the good. They've all taken that safely. Classical Milano followed by Speak of the Devil on the outside, with back in behind them Absolutely Dylan as they come to fence 5. Speak of the Devil just perhaps they're jumping on. Blake Rigg, the black and white striped sleeves, a little deeper out on the track, going a bit keenly as well, perhaps just wanting to go a bit faster than the rider is willing to allow, with similar comments applying to Hidden Cargo. Then along the inside, a recovering Ballyhegan Hero, without deeper Shaughnessy, as they come to jump another. And at the back end of the field on taking that are Oscar Ceremony, and finally Maison d'Or, who's just nudged away on the landing side. Maison d'Or having his chasing debut today, a horse who stays well over the smaller obstacles. So making the journey down towards the little dip over on the far side of the track, and towards the completion of the opening mile of this Richard Grummet Handicap Steeplechase. And it is Classical Milano leading up here from in second place, Speak of the Devil. Then in third, Absolutely Dylan, the grey jacket along the inside of Hidden Cargo and Blake Rigg, as they cross that all over it safely. Back in behind runners, Ballyhegan Hero, recent winner at Stratford-on-Avon, as they come towards fence number 8. This is a plain one. Classical Milano that time lost a little bit of ground, and Speak of the Devil has now moved on more meaningfully and has opened up by a length and a half coming into the inner loop of the home straight here at Hexham. And soon enough they will be at the halfway stage. Speak of the Devil with pushed up again to the inner Classical Milano to go on. Back in third is Hidden Cargo, then Shaughnessy, as they... Not Shaughnessy, I beg your pardon. Absolutely Dylan, as they come over the first in the home straight. Shaughnessy at the moment is in around about third last place, just being niggled along ever so slightly by Jamie Hamilton as they now come to the water. And it is Classical Milano 2 lengths ahead from Speak of the Devil in second. Then Absolutely Dylan, who takes that in third. They're all over the water absolutely fine. Fourth on landing was Hidden Cargo. They've got a circuit left to travel now. Blake Rigg is a little wider out, and then comes Ballyhegan Hero from Shaughnessy as they come to jump the next. Absolutely Dylan just tickling the top that time. Maison d'Or, The big white face still right at the back end of the field. Oscar Ceremony patiently handled as they now come to the 12th. That was an open ditch. They've all taken it safely. Classical Milano. Showing in front narrowly from Absolutely Dylan along the inside, travelling well towards the outer Speak of the Devil, and then a length or so back to Blake Rigg in fourth, Hidden Cargo races next, then Shaughnessy from Maison d'Or, who's nudged towards the outside as they come over the next fence. Bally Egan Hero, who has certainly lost a few places, that one now only has Oscar Ceremony behind, but all in all they're tightly grouped as they now race out towards the final mile of their journey. And down the far side of the track, they'll have five fences in a line, six in all left to get across, and there's still only around about 9 or 10 lengths covering the lot of them, as now Absolutely Dylan under Ryan Mannier moves to the front from Speak of the Devil. The leader in a little bit close to that one. Back in third, Classical Milano, just being bustled up once again. Then in behind runners is Hidden Cargo as they come towards the 15th fence. And it was Speak of the Devil on the outside of Absolutely Dylan. They're a couple of lengths away from Classical Milano, who's now a little more forcefully driven, with up towards the outer Blake Rigg, and then Hidden Cargo, with back in behind runners Bally Egan Hero along the inside of Oscar Ceremony, Maison d'Or, and Shaughnessy, arriving at the next fence going down the back. Slightly awkward jump there from Absolutely Dylan towards the inside, and Speak of the Devil came away with a narrow advantage as they head right across from us. So it is Speak of the Devil on the outside of Absolutely Dylan. Just two lengths back in third is Blake Rigg. Classical Milano is in fourth place, ridden along, but continues to respond. A little break back off those to Oscar Ceremony, who now moves through into a fairly distant fifth place, but still a fair way to catch up as they now come towards the third fence from home. Speak of the Devil and Absolutely Dylan with a leading pair. Four lengths away in third is Blake Rigg, then Classical Milano. Now Oscar Ceremony starts to go through the gears, has 10 lengths to find on the leader, who at the second last fence was Speak of the Devil. Absolutely Dylan is in second place now, 2.5 lengths back. Another 8 or 9 away in third is Oscar Ceremony. Then Blake Rigg is now flat to the boards in fourth. Fifth is Classical Milano, and a little break back off him to Hidden Cargo and Bally Egan Hero. Speak of the Devil is in front, coming around the corner to in second place Absolutely Dylan. There's 2 lengths between them. Oscar Ceremony is getting closer back in third, but Speak of the Devil has now poached a 3 to 4 length advantage on crossing the last and jumped it well to Absolutely Dylan, who landed in second. Back in third is Oscar Ceremony, a furlong left to go on the flat. It is Speak of the Devil in the hands of Steve Mulqueen, punched right out here, has got 5 lengths in hand to Absolutely Dylan in second, with Oscar Ceremony back in third, but going close home. This is going to be a popular winner. Speak of the Devil comes home clear, beating into second position Absolutely Dylan. Through for third was Oscar Ceremony, and Classical Milano was fourth this time round.
Well, Speak of the Devil, he's a horse who likes good ground. He doesn't like the winter months. His form tailed off a little bit after his win here at Hexham, which was back in October. He just genuinely doesn't like soft ground. Came back to form last time out, finishing second to Dolly Dancing. He's backed that up with a convincing success and positively ridden by Steve Mulqueen all the way around. Had him bang up with the pace. And you'll see here, he's given him a couple of taps just to keep him concentrating. Good shot of the last as well. Horse has come up and he springs off this good ground. Perfect ground here at Hexham this afternoon. We haven't had a non-runner. There's only 2 non-runners in the last all afternoon. And this horse, you can see, flicking his toe up the running. And he's gone and won it cosy in the end. And just a rock-solid performance from the winner. Oscar Ceremony, he's stuck on gamely. For third place, never really got into it, and Absolutely Dylan, he's backed up his last run there at Cartmel when he got beaten 7 lengths, with a similar sort of run here this afternoon for the Sue Smith Yard, and he seems to be getting his act together, and another horse who just enjoys top of the ground. But Steve Mulqueen seeing a good effect for the Lucinda Russell Yard, and this 8-year-old loves it here at Hexham, and he's doubled his tally here now. And Steve Mulqueen in good form, and Lucinda Russell, she's had a pretty good season all in all, winning the Scottish National, having a Grade 1 winner at Aintree as well, and she's backed that up with a winner here at Hexham, Alex.
Well done, Stephen.
Oh, Stephen.
Nice one.
Lion, devil, got his head back in front.
front, he probably deserved that. The last race wasn't run to suit him, and I did think he had run a great race under the circumstances. So going there, I was pretty confident of a big run again. The race worked out well, sort of lined up, and just left him do what he does and gallop and jump. And there was one or two of them who were wanting to go a bit faster, but it worked out quite well. Sort of, when they dropped back, Devil was left in front, and he pricked his ears and filled himself up again. And then when they came to pester me again, I was able to sit on him and just let him travel away. And going down the back the last time, Ryan Manny came up my inside, and I just wanted to sit on Devil all the way down the back, and he winged the two fences at the bottom of the hill, and I knew nothing would probably get by him at that stage because I knew he'd keep galloping. But no, just great for the horse, to be honest. And look, jumping is probably far, far better on that ground. Just, you know, with a bit of decent ground, he travels and jumps a lot better off it. But look, delighted. Yeah, we had a few owners there, so it's great. And yeah, hopefully we'll see more of you soon. But thanks very much.